Stinking and stinking, left, right, left, hook.
The any kid on the block. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They're slugging it out. A left to the jaw. Press this lever. He throws a right. The other a left.
The winner of this bout.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
We're now going to talk to Paul Bond in just a second. Wrote an article called Hollywood Studios Accused of Pushing Liberal Agenda Through Children's Films. He particularly talks about Happy Feet 2. We'll talk to Paul about that in just a second. 1-800-222-KBC, Larry Elder. Paul Bond is a reporter for the Hollywood Reporter. He now joins us. Paul, thank you very much for coming on. I appreciate it.
Hey, thank you for having me, Larry.
Paul, starting trouble again. Hollywood Studios Accused of Pushing Liberal Agenda Through Children's Films.
Yeah.
say it ain't so, Joe.
No, I know. Who'd have thunk it, huh, Larry?
Now tell me about Happy Feet 2.
Okay, so Happy Feet in 2006 made $42 million its opening weekend. And, you know, the big message there, of course, was environmentalism and man-made global warming is a huge problem. Fast forward 5 years, Happy Feet 2, same kinds of messages with even more liberal messages thrown in. And that took 10 days to make $42 million. So it seems like conservatives are shunning that movie, and you know, a lot of conservatives tell me they are. So
you're right, Paul Bond, that the director acknowledged that 5 years ago that he reworked the script for the first movie to amplify environmental themes.
Yeah, he said that to the Wall Street Journal 5 years ago, and you know, other directors and producers have said similar things. John Lasseter, who runs Pixar, said that, you know, he purposely made the uber bad guy in Cars 2 the oil industry as well.
So the oil industry is the bad guy in Cars 2. Has that been out already?
Yeah, Cars 2 is out. That made about 22% less than the first Cars made. So perhaps that message didn't resonate there as well either. And liberals in Hollywood, they don't usually see environmentalism as a political issue. But you got to remember that 85% of liberals see man-made global warming as a severe, devastating problem that the mainstream media portrays it as. That's the way they see it. But only 15% of conservatives view man-made global warming that way. They believe it's media hype and that the science isn't settled and that the whole issue has been very much politicized. So it's not a slam dunk like Hollywood thinks it is that everybody will accept the message of environmentalism, especially when the environmental messages are coming from actors, producers, and directors who use, you know, they see it as hypocrisy.
I'm talking to Paul Bond, reporter for The Hollywood Reporter. We're talking about his new column that he's written about where conservatives are accusing Hollywood of injecting liberal messages in children's films. Paul, you quote Kyle Smith, who writes for the New York Post, saying that he liked the first Happy Feet, but the second one promoted, quote, collectivism, feminism, international bailouts, vegetarianism, same-sex marriage, the United Nations, and even Occupy Wall Street.
Yeah, so Kyle Smith saw a lot more liberal messages in Happy Feet 2 than most people did. He actually called the movie Kitty Karl Marx.
Kitty Karl Marx.
Yeah.
Wow.
And there was actually another movie called Astro Boy that not too many people saw that actually had... The good guys in that film actually had posters of Lenin and Trotsky in their headquarters.
So, Paul, in your article, you imply that the fall off in the first from the first movie to the second movie, Happy Feet 1 to Happy Feet 2, and Cars 1 to Cars 2, might very well be that in the sequel, the liberal agenda is even more heavy-handed than in the first one.
Yeah, more heavy-handed, and plus the primary message of man-made global warming isn't resonating as much. And I said that in my story, and you know, a lot of Hollywood people read The Hollywood Reporter, actually. No surprise there, but you know, a lot of the comments I got on my story are pretty nasty when I mention that a lot of people don't believe that man-made global warming is the problem it is. And I even linked to a story about those email hacking, that the scandal where they were tricking people on the math and hiding the temperature declines. And, you know, I got criticized for even linking to that story.
I'm talking to Paul Bond, reporter for The Hollywood Reporter. This article that you've written, it also tells Hollywood that people will make decisions if they feel that their views are offended. I talked about a few weeks ago Morgan Freeman going on the Morgan Pierce show and calling Tea Party members racist. And I understand, Paul, that the percentage of conservatives who were interested in watching that movie about, was it about penguins or something that he was doing?
No, that was the dolphin tail.
Dolphin tail. The percentage of conservatives who said they wanted to see dolphin tail plummeted after he gave that interview on the Piers Morgan show.
Yeah, it did. And you know, I did a whole story. We talked about it before. A whole story about the movies that conservatives embrace and the movies that liberals embrace. And that one was trending very well among conservatives, the dolphin tail. But it fell off after that with conservatives. But the total box office probably wasn't hurt on Dolphin Tale that much because the Tea Party has been so maligned that just as many liberals all of a sudden were interested in seeing that movie after they knew that Morgan Freeman was anti-Tea Party. So as many conservatives as the movie lost, it probably gained in liberals in that particular case.
I'm talking to Paul Baum, reporter for The Hollywood Reporter. We're talking about his article, Hollywood Studios Accused of Pushing Liberal Agenda Through Children's Films. Paul, you mentioned that Hollywood does not see environmentalism as a political issue. So I would think that the people that did Happy Feet 2 don't think they're running any kind of risk by, quote, jamming this kind of stuff down the throats of the American people, end of quote.
Yeah, they don't. There's a lot of things that Hollywood perceive as, this is just mainstream, and it really isn't. Man-made global warming is not even mainstream when you add up the conservatives and the liberals. Only 47% of the general population believe it's a huge problem nowadays. So Hollywood's a little bit out of the mainstream as far as, you know, how big a problem man-made global warming is. And they're way out of the mainstream in conservative, the United States. There's about 123 million conservatives in the United States, and only 15% of them believe it's a big problem. So they don't want to take their kids there and watch their kids, be brainwashed into this message that we're all going to die unless we stop using energy.
I was going to ask you that next. You said they don't want to take their kids there. These are movies that are targeted towards children. Who makes the call when a family decides to see a children movie? Does the child make the call, or does the mom or dad make the call?
Oh, the mom and dad always make the call. They're the ones paying the money. And,
providing the transportation.
Yeah, buying the popcorn and everything.
Right. Wow. All right, so the moral to the story is that Hollywood has gotten religion now and realized that you can't make offensive pro-liberal messages and expect conservatives to see them, or what?
No, Hollywood will continue to put messages into their art. If you're an artist and you're going to spend your life making art, you're going to make that art reflect your values. So I don't see them shying away from this. They might be a little bit more mindful in the future, but I don't see them shying away completely about throwing messages that they believe in into their art. It's just that what they believe in, they have to realize, might not be mainstream, and even if they think it's mainstream.
Well, Paul, before you came on, of course, I played cuts from Susan Harris, who created Golden Girls, Marta Kaufman, who created Friends, Vin DeBono, who created MacGyver, Leonard Goldberg, who did Charlie's Angels, Fantasy Island, among other TV shows. Fred Silverman was the head of ABC, NBC, CBS. John Langley co-created Cops. And they all conceded that there was a liberal, that Hollywood was heavily liberal, that there was a liberal agenda. And one even said that if you are not a liberal in Hollywood, it will adversely affect your career.
Oh, yeah. Ben Shapiro shared those tapes with me first. So that was a big exclusive we had at the Hollywood Reporter. It became one of our biggest stories of the year when we posted all those tapes on our site. And, he miraculously got these people to be so open with him because they thought he was one of them. He thought, he was a Harvard graduate writing a book about Hollywood. They just assumed that he was a Hollywood liberal just like they are, so they really opened up to him.
Now, here's a big question, Paul, I want to leave you with. Paul Bond has been my guest. He's a reporter for The Hollywood Reporter. Given all the politically incorrect stuff that you write about, Paul, are you still able to get that front table at Spago's?
No, I don't go out much more, Larry.
All right, Paul. Thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Hey, thank you. Bye-bye.
You got it.